Hi, this is Chef Mick from Tony's Market. Welcome to my kitchen. We take great pride in the freshness of our seafood, blown in overnight 6 days a week by our suppliers. Our fish is as fresh as you can get on the coast, sometimes fresher. But sometimes frozen is better than fresh. Some boats fish for weeks on end, catching and cutting and freezing their harvest right in the boat, just minutes out of the water. Sometimes so many fish are caught at once that they're frozen for when the fresh season's over, such as Alaskan sockeye salmon. And then there's a case of fish fillets that are encrusted and seasoned and ready to cook. They are particularly handy and great cooked from frozen or thawed. It'll be your fastest meal of the week. Join me in my kitchen as we explore the benefits and how-tos of frozen fish. Our buyer is always hunting for great tasting frozen fish that's conveniently packed for quick use from the freezer. In fact, our variety is bigger than will fit in our display freezers, so our selection is always changing. Come see what we have today. If you don't see what you want, just ask. Salmon is a personal favorite and one of the healthiest fishes in the sea, particularly wild Alaska salmon, which is only caught in summer. And salmon is an excellent fish to cook from frozen, so I always keep a few pounds in the freezer. We'll start by cutting a few portions, rinsing in cold water to remove any ice, and then patting completely dry. We want all the excess water removed. Next, we'll brush with olive oil and preheat a pan, a grill, or the oven. Once it's nice and hot, roughly 375 to 425 degrees, we'll oil the pan and add the fish skin side up and set the alarm for 4 minutes. We do not season the fish yet. After 4 to 6 minutes, the first side should be nicely browned. Turn over, reduce heat, and season or top whatever you like from marinade to breadcrumbs. I use our Z-Blend seasoning for the pan-seared and the teriyaki for the grilled salmon, two of my favorite finishes. Cover and finish over medium heat, taking internal temperatures regularly. Sockeye cooks faster than any other salmon, actually any other fish I can think of, and I like it rare, so I like to remove it 110 to 115 internal and rest. It will continue to rise another 10 to 20 degrees off the heat. Since we finished cooking skin side down, it's easy to remove the fillet from the skin. These salmon fillets turned out perfectly, about medium rare inside and a nice brown and seasoned finish. Who could ask for anything more? Well, a fork and a knife would be nice. Let's move on to these haddock fillets, which is interchangeable with cod in any recipe. First, we'll lay down some foil, rinse the fish, and then pat it dry to remove all the water. Then drizzle generously with olive oil, a good squeeze of lemon, maybe the lemon zest too, and finally our Cajun seasoning, or your favorite seasoning blend. We'll cradle all in the foil so the fish poaches in the oven. Oven poaching with olive oil or butter is probably my favorite way to cook any frozen fish. It always turns out great. My mom used to make breaded cod when I was a kid and I still love it. Let's bread this second fillet. Rinse and pat dry, get some panko or other breadcrumbs, and season with our crazy seasoning salt, Italian herbs, genuine Parmigiano-Reggiano cheese, and enough olive oil to moisten the crumbs. Just like our salmon, we'll cook this fillet for 4 to 6 minutes to soften before seasoning or topping, and then returning to the heat to finish cooking, generally from 6 to 20 minutes longer. This is your basic rule for cooking almost any fish from frozen. Our oven poached haddock is an example of the second basic technique for cooking seafood from frozen. It works with just about any fish you can think of. I mainly use olive oil or butter, lemon, and seasonings, but you could go wild with all sorts of sauces, salsas, or concoctions. Generally, they should be based on olive oil or butter. I'm pleased to say these two dishes turned out incredibly well. I'd have a hard time telling them apart from fresh. Now for two of our most popular frozen dishes, our coconut mango or three tortilla encrusted tilapia fillets. These really couldn't be any easier. Just put them on a pan, roast in convection oven at 325 degrees, fan on, until it reaches at least 145 degrees. Remove from the oven and rest on the pan for a few minutes and serve. I'm using parchment paper. Nothing can stick to it and it keeps your pan clean. It's a personal favorite kitchen tool of mine. These are great as is, or try them with one of our mango sauces. Or the best condiment ever made that hardly anyone knows about, mango chutney. I love this stuff on fish, fowl, pork, lamb, and beef. It's got a sweet, complex flavor that goes great with any meat. Keep a handful of these tilapia fillets on hand for when you need something nice, but quick and easy. Here's another tasty option, frozen mahi-mahi smothered in sauce. This one is loaded with tart tropical fruit. Oh, so good. It started thawing while I wasn't looking, but that's okay. It would just be easier to do this if it was frozen solid. Lay it on foil and make a simple boat to cradle the fish in the sauce as it roasts in the oven. It's really easy and it turns out great. You could even copy this recipe and smother fresh or frozen fish fillets in our mango salsa before roasting. I'm guessing you're recognizing the oven poaching method here. It's truly one of the best, most consistent, and easiest ways to cook frozen fish. Oh, just look at that. I'd pair this with rice, succotash, or a simple squash side dish, a little salad, and maybe a bottle of Riesling or Gewürztraminer. Fresh fish is awesome, but we don't always have time to go shopping. And when you need a quick supper, frozen fish fillets are an easy and healthy solution. We have fresh fish coming into our market 6 days a week, but we also keep a nice selection of frozen fishes for your convenience. Keep a few in the freezer for when you need something quick but nice. I'm Chef Mick Rosacci. I thank you for shopping in our markets, and I thank you for joining me in my kitchen.